And thank you for joining the webinar today. I'm Amanda Jadrow, the Director of Portfolio Management at TRICHEM. As an administrative and financial solutions provider to the staffing and consulting industry, it is our philosophy to be an active member by staying abreast of the ever-changing marketplace. For that reason, TRICHEM was pleased to launch the Industry Insider webinar series designed to share our expert knowledge and resources with our fellow staffing industry colleagues. One of our core values is to build relationships and become a leading resource to staffing and consulting firms nationwide. Our presenter today is Alan Gilbert, Director of Strategic Partnerships with Essential Staff Care. With more than 20 years of experience in the professional services field, Alan has an extensive background in HR, workforce solutions, and payroll services. He is responsible for marketing of Essential Staff Care Limited medical benefit plans to clients in the staffing and other high turnover industries. Alan holds a double major in business administration and insurance and economic securities from the University of South Carolina. He is a South Carolina licensed life and health insurance agent. Before joining Essential Staff Care, Alan was the direct sales manager for Tox Corporation, a leading provider of HR, payroll, and tax consulting services. In this role, he was responsible for the sales of corporate tax consulting services to employers with greater than 5,000 employees in the eastern region of the U.S. and business development among existing customer relationships. Prior to Tox, he served as a corporate sales manager at ADP Inc., a provider of HR and payroll solutions. At ADP, Alan managed business development for pre-employment services, which included background checks, applicant tracking, and tax credit and incentive services. Gilbert has also spent years in the 1990s in the staffing industry working as an area manager for Alston Staffing. Alan resides in Greenville, South Carolina, and is an avid road cyclist. Essential Staff Care is the largest provider of ACA-compliant health benefit plans and supplemental employee benefits to the staffing industry, serving over 2,450 staffing company clients and enrolling in over 750,000 temporary employees annually. ESC offers ACA-compliant MEC plans, fully insured major medical plans, supplemental fixed indemnity plans, comprehensive employment, and ACA audit technology solutions. ESC is an American Staffing Association corporate partner and an award-winning member of the National Association of Health Underwriters. In today's Industry Insider webinar, we will cover the important updates regarding the current coronavirus pandemic and ESC fixed indemnity, MEC, and bronze major medical plans. COVID-19 has swiftly introduced enormous uncertainty into the day-to-day operations of staffing companies. The purpose of this webinar is to provide TRICHEM clients offering ESC benefits with information needed to confidently answer any employee questions that may arise regarding ESC benefits and the COVID-19. In this brief webinar, we'll discuss COVID-19 testing as it relates to our bronze, major medical, fixed indemnity, and MEC health plans, as well as ESC short-term disability benefit plan. We'll also review the ESC missed premium feature and answer any questions you may have regarding your employees' use of our benefits at this time. If you have any questions during the presentation, please use the Q&A or chat feature. And with that, I will turn the floor over to Alan.
Thank you, Amanda. I hope everybody's having a great day today. I know that you've probably attended a whole bunch of COVID-19 webinars. I promise I will not talk about washing hands, death rates, any of those kind of things. This is unprecedented times, and so we're going to talk about the things that are very germane to our business as it relates to this pandemic. And one of the first things I want to talk about is, you know, just what are our continuity plan regarding, you know, continuing to provide services and so forth. We'll also talk about various plan coverages and how they deal with COVID-19. We'll talk a little bit about the break in service, And then we'll stress the importance of offering healthcare across the board, healthcare insurance to all employees, thus eliminating the possibility of a discrimination suit down the road. So let's first talk about the ESC continuity plan. This slide would give you the impression that we're a wholly owned subsidiary. We're not. We're a privately held company headquartered in Greenville, South Carolina. I know many of you are certainly familiar with our organization, and we thank you for your business. What this wholly owned subsidiary that's being referenced in this slide is our administrator. While Essential Staff Care and our parent company Insurance Applications Group, we're essentially a broker of health insurance products. So we don't do a lot of the heavy lifting, the customer service, the billing, the claims processing. That's all done by our third party administrator, a company called PAI, which many of you I'm sure have had communications with. So they're the ones that are a wholly owned subsidiary of Blue Cross Blue Shield. And you know, they have an emergency response plan in place, as you would expect. It covers things like data security, HIPAA compliance, as well as telework protocols. You know, the one thing that's most important is if you have any questions at all, don't ever hesitate to contact our 866 customer service line. At PAI, there's probably around 250 individuals that actually answer the phone, Essential Staff Care. And it's this scalable group of highly trained claims processors and specialists that allow us to flex up and down as needed, leaning on other resources of Blue Cross Blue Shield of South Carolina as needed. So again, anything, questions, you have clients or customers or rather employees that have questions regarding their coverage, please don't hesitate to ask them to contact ESC Customer Service at 866-798-0803. Those people can answer those questions much better than you or I can. So, and they have access to the employees' data files and, you know, all the different things that would be needed to address any questions they might have. So please encourage your employees with questions related to COVID-19 or otherwise, please direct them to customer service. We also have a plan, obviously, to deal with all these different plans. So here's what I want to do. I'm going to go through the various products one by one that we offer. And we're going to talk about how COVID-19, the diagnostic testing and treatment is covered by each of the different plans. So we'll start with the granddaddy of them all, if you will, the major medical bronze plan. While it is a major medical plan, it is a high deductible plan. Very few of TRICOM's clients actually offer this plan to their employees, but some do. So what I want you to know about the bronze plan and how it covers COVID-19 diagnosis is that the doctor's office visit, the lab test, all needed for this diagnosis is covered at 100% with no cost sharing. So, and the reason why that is the case is because MEC coverage, the wellness and preventive things that are covered in a MEC plan, are also covered in a bronze plan. And those 63, 64 specific services that are outlined in the Affordable Care Act, those services must be offered at no cost to the employee in order for them to be ACA compliant. Now, naturally, COVID-19 testing wasn't already a part of bronze plans, but one of the very first executive orders that was passed by the current administration changed that to include the COVID-19 diagnosis as part of bronze plans, and thus they have to be covered with no cost sharing by the employee. So the bronze plan, the diagnosis would be covered at no cost. The treatment, however, you are determined that you had COVID-19, the treatment cost would be covered under the plan's typical cost-sharing agreement. So again, these are high deductible plans, so the treatment of COVID would include meeting the individual's deductible and then of course the plan would pay at the rate of I think it's an 80-20 payout. So that's the bronze plan. Diagnosis, no cost to the employee. Lab test, no cost to the employee. However, treatment would be covered under the normal bronze cost sharing arrangement. The fixed indemnity product, which most of you are familiar with because each of our TRICOM clients offer this product, the standard plan benefits would pay for the physician's office visit and lab work, just like it would for any doctor's office and lab test. The flat dollar amount that will be paid each day is based upon the ESC outpatient medical schedule of benefits that your specific plan has. And the reason why we have to couch it that way is that, you know, different office visits are paid at a different rate based upon the plan that you have. So for instance, the value plan would only pay $55 or $60 towards a doctor's visit, where plans 1 through 4 would pay as much as $105 towards a doctor's visit. And so it's gonna pay out the flat dollar amount as it would for any kind of, there's no special consideration for COVID-19. It would simply pay out based upon the outpatient medical benefit schedule that your plan has. So come back to that in a few minutes. The treatment would pay at the standard plan benefits. So if you were admitted into a hospital, for instance, the daily hospital fee would be paid based on the plan's benefits as outlined in your benefit summary. This one is really an interesting one that came up in our, you know, analyzation of how we would deal with COVID-19 and how our plans would. And this is a little bit, a lot of you guys don't even offer short-term disability, but if you do offer short-term disability as a voluntary product to your employees, an employee who enrolls in the ESC short-term disability plan who self-diagnoses and self-quarantines without a medical diagnosis will not be covered by the ESC short-term disability plan. It has to have a doctor's office visit and lab test specific to the formal COVID-19 diagnosis. And if that is the case, it would be covered. Obviously, the short-term disability would cover it. I skipped a bit, so let me back up. Yeah, back to this. So, in other words, in this particular case, the short-term disability, in order for you to actually receive, or an employee to actually receive their short-term disability, they cannot achieve that through self-diagnosis. They must go to a doctor, get an official diagnosis, and then, of course, submit that as part of evidence of the claim, and we would pay the short-term disability as outlined in your summary of benefits. I'm sorry if I confused anybody by switching over to the next benefit. So now we'll switch over to, this is the ACA compliant plan that most of you offer. Most TRICOM clients offer the MET plan as your ACA compliant plan. So as I discussed earlier, COVID-19 was added to the list of wellness and preventive services offered by a MET plan. A employee can go to a doctor's office in network, get a lab test, get the diagnosis, and it'll be covered at 100%, no cost sharing. But I'm gonna pause right there. Okay, because unlike the indemnity product and the major med plan, which are fully insured plans, the MET plan, many of you realize or remember that those plans are self-funded. And that phrase, self-funded, means exactly what it sounds like. It is a It is a plan whereby there is the absence of an insurance company. There is literally a claims reserve account that we are accumulating funds in on your behalf as people pay their premiums. And then as the claims come in, we pay the claims out of that claims reserve fund. And if that plan fund ever became a deficit, that would result in what's called a cash call, whereby the employer would have to pay those costs. That is the structure of a minimal essential coverage self-funded plan. So the only reason I mention this is you will want to consciously view your claims reserve account balance and do so regularly so that you don't get a surprise. While I think it's important that if someone is in fact, ill and demonstrates all the different symptoms, by all means, we need to encourage them to go to their doctor and request this test. And of course, the test would be performed at no cost sharing to the employee, but somebody's going to pay for it. It's going to be paid out of that claims reserve account. And if that runs a deficit, there would be a cash call. So all I'm suggesting is that maybe weekly, you might want to go out to the FTP, look in the SF self-funded folder, and in there it would give you your historical MEC reports, and one of those reports in one of the columns gives you what your claims reserve balance is. So you might want to just take note to check that out from time to time so that you don't have any surprises. The treatment. Okay, and this is not unique to COVID-19. The MEC plan is a wellness and preventive service. It covers plans or items that are wellness in nature or preventative in nature. The minute there's a diagnosis, MEC plans don't cover treatment. They simply cover wellness and preventive. So the treatment is not covered under a wellness plan, nor is any other treatment, not just COVID-19 treatment. Any kind of treatment is not covered under a MEC plan because that's not the purpose of a MEC plan. The purpose of a MEC plan, wellness and preventive, screening, diagnostic testing, things of that nature. But the minute there's a diagnosis, MEC plans pay nothing. So very important that we touch on that. The medical diagnosis is covered. No money out of pocket to the employee, easy, smeasy, great. But be careful, if your claims reserve runs hot, it could have a risk exposure to you, the employer. So if there's any questions on that, I'll certainly field them at the end. I want to talk a little bit now about break in service, because as we all know, the headcount at our staffing companies probably aren't today what they once were even 3 weeks ago. So let's just talk about the break in service, and this is really more of a reminder than anything else. The fixed indemnity plan actually includes a missed premium accommodation for enrollees. So if Johnny was on assignment and then the place in which he was assigned no longer needs him because they've shut their business down for the duration of this COVID-19 pandemic, Johnny's not going to be receiving a check. Well, that's okay, because our plan actually provides for an accommodation for this missed premium. And I'll go into a little bit of depth on that. It allows that all enrolled parties or all enrolled employees can make up missed premiums, and they can do so by providing a check directly to our plan administrator, PAI. But let's talk about that. If I've missed three weekly deductions and I have a claim that I need to have paid, I would want to do a cost benefit analysis if I was that employee to say, okay, I've got 3 weeks of missed premium that I'm at to pay. Let's say that that's 1998 times three, that's approximately, you know, $90 or 60, 20, yeah, 20, yeah, $60. I would be willing to pay a $60 premium if I'm looking to have a claim that is several hundred dollars paid for. Would I be willing to pay $60 for to have a, you know, a $70 claim paid? Yeah, I might choose just to pay that out of my pocket. So again, if an employee misses a premium, they still have coverage. However, they would only want to pay the missed premiums if the claim that is going to be paid is of value to them. In other words, is it worth the outlay? So then I guess the other thing I want to mention is after six missed premiums, six consecutive missed premiums that we probably are going to expect to see in this pandemic arrangement where people have missed work for six or more weeks consecutively, well, those employees would have their coverage automatically terminated by our third-party administrator, and those employees would be mailed COBRA notifications because our indemnity product is in fact eligible for coverage or for COBRA, and so is the minimal essential coverage plan is also covered through COBRA. How does COBRA work? Well, COBRA is available for an employee to continue coverage at no more than 2% above their current fixed indemnity premium, and they don't, or if they re-enroll, they would simply, you know, if they re-enroll, if they are placed back in assignment. So an employee has two different options after that six-week continuum. They can continue the COBRA, continue their coverage through COBRA. Their premium would increase by 2% above what they're currently paying. Or when they simply come back to work, they could simply re-enroll when they're placed back on assignment. So I wanted to make sure that everybody was remembering how that works. Any questions about that, direct your employees to the 866 number. Now, one of the other things that we talked about in preparation for this presentation and once we saw just how this pandemic was going to really impact the staffing industry so significantly, we wanted to remind everybody that during this pandemic and after, it's going to be crucially important that you remember to offer coverage to every single new hire. And the thought is, you know, this is different times. And we're suggesting that make sure you remember to always offer that indemnity product, always offer the MEC plan, because what you know, these are plans that pay first dollar coverage. They pay directly to the doctor and to the physician as long as they go in network. There's no paying and then waiting to get reimbursed. So it is a usable benefit for your temporary employees. But the other reason why we want to stress, make sure you always offer the plan, is because of this next point. As soon as my slides start working, there we go. Let me go back. So these plans, no deductibles, no co-payments, there's no filing of paperwork to get reimbursed as long as they go in network. And let's look at these are a national average, depending upon the region of the country. So for instance, doctor visits are ranging around the country from about $88 to $110 for a doctor's visit. Well, you see that plan one pays $105. So the enrolled employee would go to a doctor's office visit, and as long as that plan or that doctor visit costs less than $105, the employee would not pay anything for that doctor's office visit. Lab work, you know, the range of lab work, depending upon the range of the country, a region of the country, 75 to 125, our plan pays $75 per lab test per day. The chest x-ray that often accompanies these kinds of diagnosis range anywhere in the country from, you know, $75 to $120, depending on the region. Our plan pays $200 flat for a chest x-ray. So just keep that in mind. You can see how valuable these plans are to employees. But one of the other reasons we want to ensure that you're offering this to every single new hire. Adherence to this process not only protects your employees, but it protects you by ensuring that every candidate and subsequent new hire receives an offer and you either get an accept or decline of coverage. Very, very important, because if the new hire ever came back and was, or if the new hire is not offered an opportunity to enroll because they were not offered benefits, and then they suffered some kind of medical calamity, the result could be a lawsuit against you for discrimination. You didn't offer me a benefit. You didn't give me the opportunity. That's why I'm financially burdened now, because you didn't give me the opportunity to buy insurance. Just a reminder, importance not only to your ACA compliance, making sure that you make that, you know, that MEC offering to every single employee, and we also want to encourage you to make sure you get an accept or decline on the ESV indemnity product for this reason, to avoid discrimination. So those are the points. Now, before we go into questions and answers, I want to talk about one other thing that I didn't include in the presentation via a slide, but I want you to think, I would imagine that most of you do your enrollment through electronic enrollment. Well, that would be my guess. What we're finding, and this is a phenomenon that came up as a result of this pandemic, with staffing companies closing offices in many cases, they're having to look at ways to do remote hiring, where the employee doesn't even come into the office, a recruiter never even sees them. You know, it's all being done on the telephone and email. We have come up with a relatively simple remote enrollment process. So if any of you are currently using paper enrollment forms that would depend upon an employee coming into your offices, and if you in fact have your offices closed or have very limited hours, you might find the need to enroll those employees remotely. And we have developed a process, and all you would need to do, if that is of interest to you, of learning more about that remote hiring, then all you would have to do would be to contact your benefit specialist, you know, whoever your contact at ESC is, or you can simply call me or email me, and I'll get you to the right person. But we have a special department that's handling these requests. So if any of you have a need for remote enrollment, because you currently use paper, all you got to do is reach out to us, and we will address your concerns and walk you through that transition. Now, Amanda, how do I see if there are questions? How do I do that?
So if anyone has any questions, yeah, please go ahead and submit them using the chat or the Q&A feature. You'll see them come up on your screen that way. While we are waiting for people to put in their questions, could you give us some final thoughts or some suggestions? I know there was a lot of great information covered today. What's some of the biggest questions that you're getting that you want to make sure that people walk away today with a solid answer?
Yeah. Is COVID-19 testing covered in my insurance plan? That is going to be the question you're going to get. You know, we can certainly distribute this presentation so they can reference back. If there's any questions, call the 866 number. Encourage your employees to call the 866 number. The COVID testing and treatment is covered by the Bronze Plan. There are obviously some cost sharing in the treatment of the Bronze Plan. With regards to the MEC plan, the diagnosis of COVID-19 would be covered at no cost sharing to the employee, but remember, no treatment under MEC plans, not included in a MEC plan, no treatments. And then, of course, the indemnity plan kind of really designed for these kind of calamities, whereby this gives the employee the opportunity to get tested, treated, and obviously there very well could be cost out of pocket depending upon the level of treatment they receive and the cost. The only other warning, again, I don't know if I was offering a MEC plan that I would actively promote, you know, if you're feeling bad, go to the doctor, because while those plans have no cost to the employee, and that's the right thing to do, just recognize that if there's a run on these tests, and I don't think there is going to be a run on them, and here's why. I listen to a lot of coverage, I read a lot of stuff, and what I'm finding out is because the testing is somewhat sparse, they're not testing everybody. You can't just show up at a doctor's office and say, I would like to have a COVID-19 test. You got to meet all kinds of criteria, all the classic symptoms. You know, they have a triage, if you will. You know, they're not going to just give you willy-nilly anybody that requests a COVID-19 test. They're not going to give it to you. So that should help you to preserve your claims reserve, knowing that every single person with a sniffle, nose, or a cough can't get a test. So that's good to know. You do not want to, in any way, shape, or form, discourage your employees from that testing, even though it might have an impact on your claims reserve. You've got to be a good steward to your employees. So prudent regarding the MEC plan, but certainly do not ever limit someone's ability to use that, because the professionals will determine if the employee has all the symptoms necessary to be tested and for you to incur those costs. So those are the main things. Make sure you're offering a plan to every single person that darkens the door of your staffing company. And with regards to remote hiring, they don't even have to darken your door. We can figure out a way to help you enroll them without them ever coming into your office. So those are the kind of, that's the summary, if I will. I would love to, and I guess here's another encouraging point. As many of you know, I was, it spent some time in your shoes back in the 90s, and while things have changed quite a bit since I was in the business, there's still some things that are true to the staffing industry that will always be true of the staffing industry. And that is, when there's an economic downturn, staffing companies are the first to feel it. When there's a recovery, staffing companies are also the first to feel it. So I think that when we start seeing us climb out of this, this calamity, I think that employers all across this country are going to look to staffing companies as their go-to to help begin bringing people back to work. So while this is excruciatingly painful times, I think there's a light at the tunnel, and it's not a train. I think it's an economic turnaround that let's all hope and pray that it is significant and timely. So those would be my closing comments. We're here to help in any way we can. Any questions, do not hesitate to call, and I appreciate the time you've given me today.
Fantastic. Thank you for those closing remarks. Very uplifting and some really great information. Lastly, probably just making sure that people have access to that 800 number that they can share with their employees.
Let's go back. I think it's an 866 number, but let's make sure that we get that to everybody that has it written at that. It is contained in your user's manual. If you want to blow the dust off of that, it sits up on the shelf in your payroll office or wherever that might be. But let me get that quick. All right, there we go. 866-798-0803. If there's any questions at all I'm going to give you my cell phone number. If anybody has any question, they just simply want to call me direct, I'll be happy to talk with you. My direct cell phone number is 864-918-2999. So please don't hesitate to call. Don't call me at 3 a.m, but any other time, I'll be happy to discuss.
Sounds great. And you're South Carolina time zone, correct?
I am. People
are aware of that?
Yes,
East Coast
sunny,
time zone. Okay.
sunny, breezy, and beautiful today. So it's all good.
Love it. Fantastic. Well, thank you so much for taking the time to share this information with our clients. It's very important and timely. So I thank you for taking the time out of what I'm sure is a very busy schedule for you right now.
Wow. I thank you for your kind comments, and I wish everyone well.
Absolutely. So if anyone has any additional questions, feel free to reach out to either of us directly. We'd be happy to answer one-on-one. Thank you for taking the time to join us on this webinar today to talk about COVID-19 and ESC benefits. Watch for information on our next webinar session. And in the meantime, stay well. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Thanks, everyone. Bye-bye.